An Australian has been confirmed among the injured following the Sri Lankan terror attacks, which have now claimed the lives of more than 200 people. Nine correspondent Renae Henry is on the ground as government officials confirmed they had information of an imminent attack 10 days ago.
Well, right now I'm in Ground Zero in the centre of Colombo, and it feels quite eerie because of this curfew that's keeping people behind closed doors for their safety. There's not much going on the streets except for, you know, these armed soldiers and police who are trying to keep everyone safe. Over there is the Shangri-La Hotel, one of the hotels that was targeted, but right here is the Kingsbury Hotel, which clearly was targeted as well. You can see the panes of glass that have been blown out, the shards splayed all over the road here. And I'm told that it was a breakfast bar in there. It was 8:30 or 9 a.m. when this suicide bomber has struck. I understand he was standing right there in that corner. I'm told he had a backpack on. I'm told he'd been staying here for a day, mapping and plotting this out. That's what I'm being told when this bomb has gone off. And I'm hearing that 11 people alone died at this hotel, including 9 foreigners. And this country is very much one that is on tenterhooks right now. Just in the last 4 or 5 hours, there was a 6-foot pipe bomb located on the road that heads to the airport. It was gotten rid of using a controlled detonation by the Air Force. Thankfully, it seems they've been able to thwart what would have been a 9th attack following the Easter attacks from yesterday. Concerningly, local media are reporting that the Prime Minister has admitted an inadequate response to what was concerns raised 10 days ago by a head police official who said that there were threats being made by a radical Islamic group against churches in this country. The Prime Minister has now ordered an inquiry into why that information seemingly wasn't used to thwart these attacks. The latest information I'm hearing is that more than a dozen suspects are now in custody, but it has not been without sacrifice, with 3 police officers killed in the process. The latest I'm hearing in terms of fatalities among foreigners is that potentially as many as 35 foreigners have perished in these attacks. I'm hearing of Americans, British, Portuguese, Dutch, Japanese, Chinese, Australians are not on that list. But we have had confirmation this morning that an Australian was injured in this incident. The severity we're not yet too sure of. There has been a social media blackout to prevent the spread of inaccurate information and rumours. And we think in just a little bit, the curfew that has been going on here is being lifted. That will allow people to venture out of their hotels and out of their homes, whether they want to, whether they feel safe enough, though, is another matter.